Hey guys, FrozenXs here, and today I'm going to be bringing you a little bit of a different kind of video. Normally I make division builds and guides because that's what's been doing good for my channel recently, and I don't know, as much as you may say that's almost kind of a sellout, I'm just happy to, you know, get views, and some people like the video, some people disagree with me. It's kind of like more of a 75-25 split. I think some people just have a trouble accepting my opinions or really listening to me in general because I have no fan base, but you know, take what I'm about to say with a grain of salt. So yeah, I'm gonna talk about the whole Leafy and h3h3 situation, about the whole Tommy video, and yeah, this could potentially be just YouTube suicide for me. I'm finally doing good. I may end up getting a complete ton of hate from this, and you know, making both fan bases just utterly despise me, but the truth is, I really just, you know, I feel like no one has made a video explaining it and why. I don't think really anyone is too much in the wrong. Keep in mind, I am going to point out where I do think both parties are in the wrong, referring to Leafy and h3h3. Tommy in this situation did nothing wrong. Like, I mean, come on, guys. He's got death threats because he made a video that a bigger YouTube posted. There's no way he deserved any of this. If anything, like, if Leafy's fans were that pissed off, they should have gone over or just disliked the video and left it at that. I mean, you don't have to threaten people with death threats, and I'm going to get into that a bit later, though. So, the whole problem roots from the whole fanboyism phase, and I say phase because I almost feel like this is the thing that's been happening recently. This hasn't been an issue in the past, or at least not to this extent. There really haven't been any YouTubers that had such a big fan base that they could pretty much boycott and ruin other YouTubers' lives and careers. Now, with the exception to that being PewDiePie, because I'm sure we all remember that time or period of time where if PewDiePie played a video game, any other video game another YouTuber played was, oh my god, you copied PewDiePie, dislike. I'm sorry, that's just ignorant and arrogant 12-year-olds, and I'm glad that phase ended. You can't say that one YouTuber is the only YouTuber that can play a video game. Anyone that bought the game has copyright rights to record the game. And I know that in games alphas and betas, a lot of developers like to say, oh, you're not allowed to record this, but if you paid money for their product, what you do with it is your business. If you record it, that's up to you. They may try and sue you, which could screw you over with legal costs, because even if they don't have a legal case there, you're screwed. But regardless, it's the same thing with jailbreaking a phone. If it's not illegal to jailbreak a phone, they can void your warranty, but you are allowed to do what you want with your phone. No one can tell you the otherwise. And it's illegal to download apps that normally cost money for free, but Apple can't call the cops because you jailbroke your phone, which is a very common misconception. And I'm getting really far off topic here, but what I was talking about is just how the fanboys are the real root of this problem. Leafy never directly said to go over to his channel and give him hate, none of that, and I find that most of this is just kids who are trying to make their favorite YouTubers happy, or make their favorite YouTubers notice them and get a shout out, and they're not realizing the real world repercussions to this kind of thing. And leaving death threats, as many of you know, is a felony. And I don't know what state you're from, but in Pennsylvania, it's a very severe felony. You can actually go to jail for several years. I don't know this for a fact, but I'm pretty sure it carries a minimum sentence. So if you get convicted of it, or found guilty of it, to put it another way, you have to go to prison for a minimum term. There's no argument to that. So I really don't think these kids who are leaving these death threats understand exactly what they're saying, especially because of just the amount of stupidity and arrogance that there is to it. They're saying things like, oh, I'm gonna find you and I'm gonna fucking rape you and your family, I'm gonna fucking kill you. Well, I don't think they understand that if you went to someone else's house, and Pennsylvania, Texas, and Maine have what are called castle defense laws, where if someone enters your property without your permission, you can shoot them on sight. So I don't think saying, oh, I'm going to show up at your house is going to help your issue. Because if people start saying, oh, I'm going to show up at your house, well, I'm going to let you guys know that I own an AR-15, a SCAR-L, both semi-automatic, and a Kimber 1911. The Kimber's under my mom's name because I'm not 21, but she likes to shoot guns too. And we both have access to the gun safe. If people start threatening us, I'm just going to take one of the guns, leave it in my room. If someone comes on my property and starts yelling, I'm going to kill you, I'm going to dial the police and just say, all right, come pick this guy up. If they try and break into my house, I'm going to shoot you. I don't want to have to shoot a person, and I'm not saying this in a threatening manner, but you can't go to someone else's house. You can't go on someone's property. In any state, you can go ahead and shoot someone who's threatening you on your own property. But in Pennsylvania, they don't even have to be threatening you, is how harsh it is here. If someone is just trying to find entry to your house or even refusing to leave your property, you can shoot them. And that's, as crazy as that may sound, it's a fucking law, and you can get away with it. You cannot go on other people's property. But regardless, you can't threaten people either, because if you threaten people, you can still go to prison for just that. And if someone does call the police, it's really not that hard to track someone down. Especially through YouTube comments. If they subpoena Google, who owns YouTube, I'm sure many of you know that by now. If Google gets subpoenaed asking for the ISP of certain accounts who are making death threats, they are legally obligated to comply. The ISP will then be given over to the police. The police will investigate the ISP, find the IP address, and go arrest the responsible parties. And even if it's not you, if someone has your account and they're making death threats on your account, you can get arrested for that too. So don't think like, oh, I'm just going to make up a different name or this, that, or the other thing. Because they will still track your IP. And before you think, oh, I'm a super elite hacker, I have a proxy or a VPN. Well, a lot of people think when, oh, I have a VPN that doesn't store data logs. Well, you need to get off your high fucking horse, you complete idiot, because even if your VPN doesn't store data logs, they are still legally bound to comply to subpoenas. They have to hand over all the logs they have. Sure, none of it is labeled or organized, but they will find who sent the message. And if you made a big enough death threat and pissed off the right people, you will get arrested. That's why if you go to a Donald Trump video, sure, there are people saying you're an idiot, blah, 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 this, that, or the other thing, but I'm sure there aren't very many people saying, I'm gonna come rape you and your family and then shoot you, because the FBI would actually take that as a terroristic death threat, because if you threaten a politician, it becomes terrorism, or at least it does in the state of Pennsylvania. Again, I understand the laws in PA, nowhere else, it differs wherever you live, and they will track you down. You can't threaten a politician. Now, because we're talking about a small YouTuber, sure, no police are going to find this guy, but say that this guy gets shot in a fluke robbery on the street. Tommy gets shot in a fluke robbery on the street, and I really hope this doesn't happen. I feel bad for Tommy in this whole situation. If he gets shot and killed, guess what? They're going to investigate everyone that made a death threat, and every single fucking one of you will go to prison for it, because if someone dies and you happen to threaten them around the same time by saying, I'm going to shoot you, well, guess fucking what? Even if you didn't shoot them, you just set yourself up to get tracked down and found guilty of at least issuing death threats. And if you live near him, they may even try you for murder. And even if you get acquitted of murder and only get the felony death threat, good fucking luck recovering your life from that. So take this fair warning, do not make death threats. You will ruin your fucking life, okay? You're not going to accomplish anything. Saying you're going to kill someone is never going to make them change their opinion. I mean, look at ISIS. We're bombing them. Do you see them changing their ways? Like going, oh yes, America, you're right. After you dropped all your bombs on us, now we understand why we shouldn't hurt you guys. Are you fucking kidding me? No! Okay, violence is not the goddamn answer, and I think that's one of the biggest issues. Now, there is a place for violence we were attacked in 9/11, blah, 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 but that's not this video. And I, that sounded terrible. I just said blah, blah, blah to 9/11. That's fucking awful. What I meant by that, more realistically, was you can't just fucking threaten violence on everyone who has a different opinion than you. If they attack you first, well, that's one thing. But if someone disagrees with your thought process and you think that violence is the answer, one, you're a douchebag, and two, you're the one that deserves to get shot because you're the one that's causing violence in the fucking world in the first place. So now I'm gonna segue out of that and more into talking about both Leafy and h3h3. In both these segments, I'm gonna more or less talk about why I don't think either party has, you know, too much of a blame in the situation, and then after I say or try and defend them a little bit, that's when I'm gonna kind of point out where they really aren't too, they're not, I don't know how to put it, they're not, like, it's a hard way to put it, but we almost put them up on a pedestal because they're big YouTubers and we see that they can do no wrong because you only see a small portion of their life, what they turn on camera. Like, I personally watch Roman Atwood's vlogs. I know he fakes pranks. I don't really care. I mean, his vlogs make me want to be a better person, and that's that. I don't really give a shit what else has to go on with that. I mean, he could turn out to, you know, be a completely fake character on the camera, but it doesn't matter because his videos still make me want to be a better person. Even if that's not actually him, I feel like I'm a better person from watching those videos. So, let's talk about Leafy. First of all, if you don't know what happened, Leafy made a video criticizing an autistic kid who he made a video of him saving a woman's eggs from on top of her car while she was pulling away. And it turned, like, nothing really was said in the video that was too different than regular Leafy content. If you subscribe to Leafy, that's kind of what you expected. Personally, I subscribed to Leafy for his stories. I thought his stories were really interesting. I thought I learned a lot from them. You almost learn life experiences from listening to other YouTubers and just listen to what happened in their life so you don't make the same mistakes they did and you can better yourself just a little bit. But in this video, or, well, not in this video, just recently he's turned into more of a YouTube critic is really the term. I don't like the term commentator because that just, I don't know. Commentator does, they're not really commentating on anything. They play a part of a video and then they critique it, and they're a YouTube critic. So that's just my opinion on what they should be called, but that's really what happened. He made fun of the autistic kid's video, and then his fan base, which I'm sure you know, Leafy has a very, very vocal fan base. I mean, the whole hissing thing that went on for at least a month, holy shit, every video click on, or you would click on, would just hiss fucking everywhere. But where shit went bad was when his fanboys decided that, okay, we're gonna go threaten to kill this person and completely hate on this person, and they really had more or less a mental breakdown because of it. And really, who wouldn't? If you're in a situation where hundreds, if not hundreds of thousands of people are telling you to kill yourself, or I'm gonna kill you, I know where you live, blah blah blah, yeah, you get scared for your life. And I'm sure, like, if it happened to me, I wouldn't really worry too much. You know, I have my guns at my home. Once I turn 21, I'll concealed carry. If anyone really attacks me, I'll feel defended. And if I die, you know, I trust our justice system to find the guy that killed me. You know, that sounds terrible, but whatever. But it would really take a toll on people. And I see why this guy had such an issue with it. Like, and I don't mean that I said such an issue with it. I mean, like, he had a full-out mental breakdown. He made a video of him crying, and I felt really bad for the guy because he was trying to make videos. The overall message was, let's try and make the world a better place one good deed at a time. And he really just got shit all over because he wanted to do something good for the world. And I think that's really, really just shit of the internet. It's not anything I would expect from the internet, or wouldn't expect from the internet, because let's face it, the internet is just everyone shitting on each other to make themselves feel better now. But this guy was hurting no one by uploading these videos, and Leafy's fans took his video way out of proportion. He didn't tell them to go over there and kill himself. He laughed at the video, thought it was a funny intro, thought the kid was being, you know, like, weird and making these people feel uncomfortable, but he never said, you know, okay, let's go fucking ruin this guy's life. Let's make sure he never uploads another video to YouTube. If he said that, well, then I'm pretty sure Leafy would actually be in legal trouble right now, because if you say attack this person and people say, okay, I will start attacking them, and they start giving them death threats, you are an accomplice to that, and so you will get arrested for that as well. So, yeah, you can't just tell people to go attack one another. I mean, thinly veiled threats are always a thing, but I listened to the video twice now, and there are no thinly veiled, okay, go over to his video and attack him. And I've watched quite a few of Leafy videos. He's never told his fans to go over and attack these people. But the problem is, they always fucking do. Because I don't know what it is about Leafy's fan base, it's just, they're extremely vocal, like I said before. And they are very, very, like, filled with hate, almost. I don't want to say, like, they're Nazis or anything, but, jeez, these people really hate everyone. And I don't see them getting it from Leafy. Leafy critiques people's videos, makes fun of it, you know, gets a couple laughs out at other people's expense. But then his fans just take it as, we need this person to be dead. I don't understand where the line got blurred there, but obviously the message isn't being received. Now, a little bit in Leafy's defense, I want to say that the guy, I mean this in a nice way, he doesn't, and this, well, I don't know why I said I mean this in a nice way, it's kind of is a nice thing to say, but he doesn't seem autistic, he just seems a little weird. And I don't know if that's just me, I have a member of my family who's also autistic, but he's a very high-functioning person, and I would honestly, I would have had no fucking idea that he was autistic unless anyone ever told me, and I think no less of him because I know it. He's just my cousin. He's just, you know, that's, like, there's nothing weird about him. It's just he has, you know, a mental disorder, and to an extent, I've had a mental disorder. I more or less went through depression before. That led to a long, long issue with Xanax, and I don't want to talk about that too much because I've put that life behind me, but it's really just, if when people start making fun of you for your shortcomings, like when people would call me a junkie and shit like that, it really hurt because it's not something, I mean, sure, in my situation, I could have controlled it. At any point, you can just put down the pill, but that's a lot easier said than done, and I'm not going to get into that this video. In his situation, he can't just stop being autistic, and a lot of people were making fun of him because he was autistic, and that is one of the most pathetic things I think a human can do, is make fun of another human because they have a mental disorder. That's like making fun of an amputee who came back because he got his arm blown off in Iraq. Like, sure, you can say, oh, if he didn't join the army, he would still have both his arms, but what kind of fucking dickhead would do that? No one. And to a certain extent, no one would do that because you don't fuck with the army, and plenty of people will come after you. I think his fans targeted Tommy because they knew, oh, this guy has, what, like, maybe a few thousand subscribers at most? I don't even know, but they targeted him because they knew he would not, there would be no repercussions. He wouldn't be able to do anything. He doesn't have enough fans to be able to make a statement, but thankfully, some people did speak out and got the shit shut down. Like, it really got to the point where it was basically fans. One fan was saying, I'm going to kill Tommy, and then another fan was going to say, I'm going to fucking kill you. Which, Jesus Christ, is that really what the internet's come to? We all just have to threaten to kill each other to just get peace? Is our peace just going to, from this point on, just going to be not, like, agreeing mutually that we're all going to kill each other if we say something wrong? I don't think that's what the internet was made for, but then again, the first thing ever sold on the internet was marijuana. So, you know, cheers to those guys, but I don't know. The internet got off to a bad start right away right there. Now, going into this a little bit deeper, he needs to make a video talking to his fans. I think Leafy, Pyrocynical, Luna, all the other commentators, official Duck Studios, all of them need to make a video talking to their fans saying, like, listen, do not fucking go around and attack other people because you saw my video and I made fun of someone. It's satire. It's funny. You don't watch John Oliver see that he made fun of Donald Trump for having tiny hands or making a stupid statement. You don't then go say, I'm going to go fucking murder Donald Trump. No one does that. Okay? It's satire. It's supposed to be funny. You're supposed to get a laugh of it, and that's the end of it. Don't take it any further than that. Realistically, you shouldn't even be going over to watch their video. Because if you're going over there to watch their video, I mean, you're most likely going to dislike it or just leave a hate comment anyway. And why? Why do you need to do that? If you think this guy was such an asshole in the video, or you really wanted to make fun of this autistic kid because you're such a dickhead and you want to do that, then leave it in fucking Leafy's comments. You don't go around spreading your shit everywhere, okay? You shit in the toilet and you don't smear it on the walls. Just keep it in one spot. If you think that Leafy's inciting this, then maybe you should be talking to Leafy about it, not going over and just threatening to fucking kill people. But I see him making the video soon, but I know for a long time he's talked about how him and Pyrocynical are in the talks about making a video just getting on the same level as their fans and explaining to them, like, listen, you guys are blowing this way out of proportion. But I think up until this point, they've never really done that because it hasn't been that big of a problem. Sure, like, they've made videos and those people in the videos they made fun of got some hate, blah, 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 but it's never been on this kind of scale where it's almost, like, newsworthy that this guy's getting so many death threats. I wouldn't be surprised if the news actually picked up on it. Which, that's just really ridiculous. I can't believe they let their channels get to the point where it's almost just channels of hate, just spreading a message of hate. Like, and I don't mean, like, they're hateful people. It's just their fans that did it. It's not them. To an extent, I feel like they've all, you know, went into this world of creating clickbait titles that the titles almost incite more hate than the actual videos do. Like, the cringiest kid in the entire planet. Like, that's borderline just... I don't really know what that's borderline. That was a stupid statement. But I don't see why you would label your video that. Why not just say, this kid is really awkward? Well, I know why. Because that video wouldn't get as many views. You gotta single that kid out and make it seem like they are just these worst, like, scum of the fucking cancer of the internet. And that's not what they're even doing in their video. Their video is mostly just satire. It's almost like if you watch John Oliver, John Stewart, well, it's Trevor Noah now, but they make fun of the news. They make satire of it. It's supposed to be funny. And they never really incite hate in their messages. They're just trying to tell the news in a different fashion, and they're doing a similar thing. Sorry, I kind of had a bit of a lisp there. That's quite embarrassing, but they are doing a similar thing. They're just making a message, or more or less trying to broadcast their opinion in a different light, and that's gotten misconstrued exponentially as they haven't really said, like, listen, guys, this shit's really just my opinion. I think it's funny. You're subscribed to me because you think it's funny, but that should be the end of this relationship, and it shouldn't be you subscribe to me, you watch my videos, and you become my little fucking soldier that goes around threatening to kill people. That's at no point the goddamn subscribe button agreement. It's really not. Now, I really want to cover the whole bullying situation of Leafy. Everyone's calling Leafy a bully, and I don't agree with that. And I know I may get some hate from that, but I don't think he's a bully in the slightest. Honestly, if I look back at my high school, a lot of the people who bullied me, I later became friends with because through the bullying, they really just forged my personality. They made me not be such a fucking annoying little prick. Because I used to be this fat, really fat kid that just was obsessed with computers, and anyone who disagreed with him was like, oh, I'm gonna hack you. And keep in mind, at the time, my version of hack was I had a DDoS client, and I thought I was the most elite hacksaw in the entire fucking world because of that, and I could just boot people offline, and therefore people just didn't want to hang out with me, and I got bullied for it. And, you know, it was really just so fucking stupid on my part. I brought it on myself. I later became friends with those people. I'm now not fat. I mean, that's not really important. But I've, you know, I'm still a cybersecurity major because I love computers, and I love, you know, I don't really like the word hacking. I prefer networking or social engineering because I like the talking side of it. I'm more of a talker than I really am a programmer. And I've become a much better person through the, you know, the things they've said to me, and which a lot of it was hateful and a lot of it was really mean. And, you know, at the time it hurt me, but if I didn't change, I'd still probably be that same stupid kid who couldn't make friends or do anything. So I'm actually really, really glad that I, you know, had people to tell me, like, listen, you know, you're an asshole and we're going to treat you like shit because you're an asshole. And it really happened to me. I don't see myself being in the position I am right now. I feel I'm smarter, I'm better because of it, I'm more motivated to be friendly to people, and I try and just be a good person to almost everyone I meet, with the exception of just the people you meet who are pure cunts. And I don't really consider what they did to me bullying anymore. I almost consider it real-life criticism, almost in the same way where you hand in your test and you get criticized on how well you did on the test. Your teacher... And I know this may piss some people off with this example, but your teacher does not give extra credit to autistic kids. And a matter of fact, most autistic people are so barely autistic, your teacher doesn't even know, and they don't have a list of it, and it's not like they're going to be like, oh, okay, well, he gets plus 10 on every test because he has a mental illness. They're preparing you for the real world, and in the real world, people are fucking dickheads. And I think we can all agree to that. Everyone from your boss to your family, and even sometimes the people you love, like your girlfriend and your friends, like, they can really hurt you, and they can really be dicks and say hateful things that really fuck up your day, fuck up your week, and sometimes fuck up your life. I'm sure you've all went through that breakup before where the girl said something or the guy said something that really hurt you, and it took you weeks or months to recover from that until it just finally clicked in your head. Who the fuck cares what they thought? What a fucking cunt. And it just really, it's more or less the issue of trying to get people to understand that if you're being criticized, you can't take it too personally. Even if you're, you know, the people who are criticizing you are saying really hateful stuff. I mean, watch Total Biscuit watch an hour of his content. Find some game reviews. He will fucking rip indie games apart. Indie games where there's only one guy that's been working on it. It's probably been the only thing he's working on for the last 2 years. He probably took a loan out. He's really just like, you know, he's probably put his entire life on hold to make this game. And then just like that, one unhappy guy who has like 2 or 3 million subscribers just tears him a new asshole. And a lot of the times those people get angry, and I know Total Biscuit's been, or I think someone tried to sue him before. I don't know if that ever really happened. But regardless, if someone just says really hateful shit about the content you make, well, you need to take the criticism and look where you can improve on it. Just the same way where once you get over that, oh my god, fuck that cunt part of your, you know, relationship, you need to look at what you did wrong in your relationship and how you're not going to fuck up like that again. Because if you were the one that got broken up with, well, let's face it, you did something wrong. We can all agree to that. You don't need to deny it. You're not dating the person anymore. So figure out what you did wrong and don't make the same mistakes. It's really that simple. And if bullying is considered criticism, well then, every teacher I've ever had that said, oh, well, this sentence was poorly worded, or you didn't carry this decimal over, is a bully too. And that's just not true. They're just telling me, like, you did this wrong, you're not going to get full credit because you did it wrong, don't do it wrong again. And that's kind of what Leafy's doing. He's not going around to YouTubers going, wow, this guy makes such great content, everyone go subscribe to this guy. He's going around saying, like, okay, this kid is making the dumbest videos in the world, or this guy is just really, really just, you know, thinking that people are way into this fantasy thing or one thing or another. I'm trying too hard to come up with examples that won't offend too many people, but let's face it, I'm going to get a lot of hate for this video in the first place. I just hope you guys understand this shit is my opinion. But yeah, he's just telling them, like, okay, you know, you may have a very, very strong passion for this, But if your passion is something that the internet doesn't share the same passion with, or the majority of people don't share the same passion with, well, you can't really be surprised when people make videos that don't agree with you. They're even making fun of you to an extent. I mean, I'm sure people will make fun of my videos. You know, I have 18 subscribers as of right now. My first 6 or 9 division videos had an audio desync in them because I'm a complete fucking retard. And, you know, I'm an idiot. And if someone wants to criticize my videos, I'm not going to just be like, okay, I'm quitting YouTube. I can't do this anymore. I'm going to go, okay, well, I need to stop being an idiot with my recording. I need to pay more attention. I need to talk more in the video. I need to, you know, be funnier, this, that, or the other thing. Take notes on what I'm doing wrong, and I'll fix it. You know, but a lot of times I just get a dislike and then people leaving a comment. Like the one guy on my Why the Dark Zone is Broken video, he just goes, oh, well, blah, 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 you're just angry because you don't have all the good gear. Well, I think he missed the entire point of my video, and I even pointed that out to him. I'm not angry because I don't have the gear. I'm saying if I'm working towards that gear, I don't think I should be fighting a player who has all the best gear in the game when I just turned level 30 and can hardly stand up to the AI in the fucking Dark Zone. How is that fair? How is that creating an enjoyable experience for me? Sure, you're having a blast because you're going around on a fucking murder spree, and that's because you bought the game on the first day and you played it more and you earned that gear. But the people who have shit to do, like, I'm in college, I couldn't get to level 30 until, you know, like, a week after the game released. I'm still not even level 30 in the Dark Zone, and we're past 2 weeks of the game's release. We're closing in on 2.5 or 3 weeks, I don't even remember anymore. And I still don't have gear that can really stand up to the high-end stuff, and I find that I don't have an enjoyable time with PvP in the Dark Zone because of it. But yet, the people who have different mindsets than me, rather than listening to me, they just dislike the video and just go, okay, whatever. And, you know, to an extent, I can be angry about it, but I can't. You know, there's nothing I can do about it. Those people are still going to want to go and have the best gear in the game and fight complete noobs, just the same way that players with brand new, you know, or with a Humvee GPK will drive around on the coast in DayZ and kill, you know, fresh spawns that have no gear or anything at all. It's just going to be part of the game, and you have to get over it. So, you know, I'm getting really off topic again, but I'm just trying to point out that criticism is not bullying. Criticizing people's content is a way of making them get better at the content. Total Biscuit's reasoning for making videos is that he wants video game creators to stop being lazy pieces of shit, just in the same way Leafy doesn't want content creators just uploading random shit that's really terrible. And for whatever reason, we're in this phase where terrible content that people feel is cringeworthy. I really hate the word cringe. Oh my god. But where people are uploading content that they find cringeworthy, and that's getting views. And maybe I'm just hating on it because, you know, I'm barely getting, you know, a few hundred views a day, which actually I'm quite happy that I'm getting a few hundred views a day. Thank you guys so much. But these people are getting so many views for just going out in public and being general idiots. Like, and I don't agree with it either, just as much as Leafy doesn't, and he's trying to criticize it. And I'm going to say it, and I'm going to probably get really shit on for this, but the guy, even if he's autistic, you should not go around just putting cameras in people's faces. He actually at one point stuck the camera in her car. Like, guys, it doesn't matter what mental disability you have, you need to be taught that's not how society works. People want their personal space. If you want to record someone, ask them, okay? You just ask someone if they want to be in a video. If they say no, that's the end of it. Don't nag them. Don't hate them. Just let that be the end of it. But don't flick on your camera, shove it in their car, and force them to be a part of your video because you did a good deed. And I think Leafy was just trying to get this guy or this kid to... I don't know whether he'd use guy or kid because I don't know how old he is. He looks like he's in his early 20s. So I'm going to go with guy because I'm 19. So I still consider myself a kid in most, you know, aspects. But, you know, he just was trying to tell this kid in, you know, probably more mean terms than he needed to. Like, this isn't how people in society act. And even with a mental disability, you can't do this. And I know that sounds really terrible, but I got to the point with my issues where, like, being depressed all the time and just taking pills to numb the pain, just, it doesn't, you can't act like that. I can sit there and say I have a mental disability all I want, you know, I have this, that, or the other thing, I have a genetic problem, blah, 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 my life sucks. I can go on for hours about why I can be depressed, or I can just get over it and realize that's not how society works, and if I'm going to be functional, and I know a bunch of you are saying, like, fuck society, and I agree to that to an extent, but you need to be able to support yourself to the point where I'm not just sitting in my room just, like, being a complete loser, you know, fantasizing over what my life could have been when I could just get out there and try and fix what's wrong with it and try and be a functional part of society and do my best. I don't ever feel like I'm going to fully be a great part of society because I've, you know, made a lot of mistakes in my past. I have trouble in college because, yeah, I don't really do well in gen ed classes. I'm good at computers, and that's literally where my skill set ends. I can't write, I'm not very good at reading, and that's pretty much it. But I don't just sit there and say, okay, I'm never going to be able to pass college. I just put my nose in a fucking book, I read for 8 hours a day, fucking torture myself, and I just, when I'm done, I smoke some pot to get over it, because, you know, I may not be exactly happy with my life, but sitting here not being happy about it isn't going to fix the problem. Just the same way as sitting there and saying that, oh, I'm autistic, you can't make fun of me, isn't going to fix the problem. Just, you have to understand that to really get people's respect, you need to, you know, make content that isn't going to make other people feel awkward. You're putting people, and not just yourself, in a weird position. I personally, if someone, even if they saved the eggs off my car, if they shoved a camera in my car, I'd push the camera away and say, get the fuck out of here. Like, I would not want someone shoving a camera in my car, in my face, recording me. You don't know what these people are going to use the footage for. Have no idea how someone can edit footage nowadays. It's really just, some people just don't want that shit on the internet, and there's a reason I don't make vlogs. I don't particularly want to put my face on the internet or all over the internet. I mean, I don't think I'm ugly or anything, but I don't exactly think I'm attractive, so I don't do vlogs. But I'm not saying that the Tommy is unattractive or anything like that. I'm just saying why I don't. So, with that all being said, I hope you guys don't hate me for what I just said there, but to an extent, he can't shove a camera in people's faces. I'm sorry. Like, it's illegal for paparazzi to touch another person. It's the same way as it, or just as it's illegal for them to shove a camera in their car. That's personal property. They own that car. It's still trespassing if you intrude on their property without permission, and shoving a camera in someone's car, believe it or not, counts as trespassing. So don't do that. That's really all I'm saying here. And Leafy, he was a lot, you know, obviously he was a lot meaner about it, but that's what his channel is. He makes satire. Do you think John Oliver needs to make fun of Donald Trump's hands to get his point across? No, Donald Trump talking will be enough to, you know, get his point across. No one needs to say anything. That idiot opening his mouth will get your fucking point across. With that being said, I still think he's probably one of the better candidates for the race, because I will not vote for Hillary Clinton under any circumstance. I would vote for fucking anyone, like goddamn Kim Kardashian, before I let that stupid bimbo of Hillary Clinton in office. And I may make another video on why I fucking hate Hillary Clinton, but that's getting left out of this video. So I'm gonna try and stop the Leafy part here, because I'm probably at almost 20-30 minutes of talking now, so I'm going to try and get into H3H3 and where I think he was wrong and where I think he was right. So first of all, I want to thank H3H3 for, he was the one that brought all this shit to a halt. Like, if it weren't for him, I bet Leafy's fans would still be attacking this Tommy guy. Thank fucking God H3H3 made a video and just put an end to this shit. At the same time though, his video was more of him being passive aggressive towards Leafy. And Leafy Leafy is a good friend of his. He admits that in the video, and he didn't really, he seemed like he didn't want to do the video in the first place, which I believe him. I wouldn't want to make a video hating on one of my friends. None of them make YouTube videos, and I haven't really met any other YouTubers, but if I did, I wouldn't want to make fun of them, because, you know, I try and stay friends with my friends until they fuck me over. But at the same time, H3H3 had to make that video. And I'm really happy he did, because if he didn't, like I said, this shit would still be going on. So, I feel like he could have done a better job, though. If he would have more or less pointed out that, okay, Leafy isn't the one inciting this hate. He's just, you know, making satire of it. But instead, H3H3 kind of just said, okay, well, we do more research into this, so therefore it's okay for us to make these kind of satire videos, but if you do it in a different manner than me, it's hate. And I agree with him kind of halfway on that. I feel like Leafy needs to stop uploading a video every day. Or if he is, he needs to make it like commentaries like once every third day. He needs to do some fucking research in the video he's doing. You can't just go up and just decide, okay, I'm going to make fun of this kid on the internet today. I don't understand where he got that wrong, because he used to make really great content. His kids at DDoS videos were hilarious. His stories about him doing drugs, which, by the way, kids, please don't do drugs. Seriously, don't watch a YouTuber who talks about how they had a fun or they had a funny experience on a drug and think, oh, I gotta do this so I have a cool story too. No. Trust me, from a lot of experience, drugs are a lot more pain than they're actually fun. So, yeah, and I'm sure a lot of you are like, oh, nah, man, college is the best. You know, pills are the greatest. Well, enjoy your 2.1 GPA, you know. That's all I'm gonna really say to that. So, if H3H3 really wanted to fix the problem, he really should have just more or less addressed the issue that is the community. And we're really in a community now where everyone is shitting on everyone to make themselves feel better. And to pick on the little guy is probably the easiest thing to do. And I'm going to bring up the fact that the reason I became so good at cybersecurity and computers in general is because I was bullied. And I have a very strong feeling a lot of these people who bully other people on the internet are people who get bullied in real life and then just misplace that anger. Rather than just accepting, okay, this person doesn't like me, I'm just going to ignore them, or I'm going to just try and, you know, not be as big of a dick or piss them off as much, then, you know, why, like, I completely lost my train of thought there, but if you're going to make a video just saying that Leafy is the hate of it, he really should have had more evidence to support it. He kind of just pointed out how he targets weak or, like, smaller people, and I don't really like how he used the term targets, because he's not really targeting people. He's, you know, making satire. It's like, it'd be the same way as saying John Oliver is targeting Donald Trump. Well, Donald Trump is kind of putting a target on his back by the shit he's saying, just the same way these people are by making cringeworthy, or they call themselves cringe content, which, if you're putting yourself under that label, then I don't understand how you can get upset when people make fun of you. Like, Donald Trump, sure, he gets upset that people make fun of how he has small hands, which he actually doesn't, and I don't understand where that started, but whatever. But when people say Donald Trump has small hands, his solution isn't everyone is such an asshole, they're bullying me, oh my god, I'm being targeted because I'm a rich politician. He just makes, you know, a comeback and says, okay, well, you did this, that, or this thing wrong. And if you remember Leafy and Mr. Darkness, I applaud Mr. Darkness for the way he handled it. I mean, sure, he made a video crying too about how he lost his girlfriend, but rather than just sit there and say, oh my god, Leafy's bullying me, he tore Leafy a new fucking asshole. Like, he really did. And, you know, and I'm not trying to say that what Tommy did was wrong in any sense of the matter, because he, like, to an extent, Leafy was kind of wrong, and I think Leafy does know that. He made an apology video, although a shit apology video. He more or less thanked his fans for the support they gave him. Like, could you be any more of a self-centered douchebag? Like, really, Calvin? I didn't have any issue with you up until I watched that apology video, which almost made me unsubscribe for your channel. Because you're like, thank you guys for your support. It's like, dude, what fucking support do you need, okay? It's the other guy that's getting the death threats, you fucking first world little bitch. Like, I really, you know, you can ask any of my friends. I've always said I want to meet Calvin. Like, he's part of the reason I started making YouTube videos, because his stories and stuff really inspired me. I love Calvin, but I don't know. I felt like he was a bit of a douchebag in that video, and it's kind of, he's in a hard situation where he doesn't really know what to say. Like, everything he says right now is going to be, you're a douchebag. Personally, he should take a break from the making fun of people videos. He needs to go back to stories, talking about shit like that. Talk about his life, make fun of his own life mistakes rather than other people's. He needs to do that for a while, primarily focus his videos on his stories, and then every once in a while, sure, throw in a commentary in there, but be sure you're making it a commentary that isn't gonna fucking invoke half the internet to get pissed off, get you on Keemstar for being a bully, make h3h3 make a video against his friends. Like, he just caused so much shit with that video, and I really feel like it's because he's sold out more than I have. I started making videos that did well, but at least they were the same video. Like, I'm making the Division videos. The Division videos that I now make are doing better, and I'm going to keep making them that way. But he just found that, okay, making fun of people is how I can get the most views and the most subscribers. I'm going to go with that. And that's why I haven't really watched Leafy recently. I check back every so often and listen to his stories, but I'm not too interested in his commentaries. Like, same thing with Official Duck Studios. He made fun of the same guy. I subscribed to him for his Fallout 4 content. That's all I watch. He makes commentaries and other shit, but I don't know. That's not what I subscribe to him for. He makes funny Fallout 4 videos, and that's that. And I feel like he's almost sold out, too. He doesn't really... He still makes Fallout 4 videos, so I'm not going to say he's gotten too bad, but he's completely switched over to really commentaries as well, because right now that's a very prominent thing in the YouTube community, and I guess this is technically a commentary, but I'm more or less trying to address the issue. I guess I'll try and do commentaries, but not in the sense of making fun of people, more or less commentating over footage I have and just talking about issues I have with the society, the YouTube community, and just things in general. Just get my opinion out there and let's see if people agree or disagree with me, because a big part of the world is accepting that your opinions can be wrong. A lot of people think the word opinion means, oh, everyone can have their own opinion. Well, you can say the Nazis had their own opinion, okay? They were wrong. I think we can all agree the Nazis were wrong. If anyone wants to disagree with that, you go ahead and commit internet suicide in the comment section and watch everyone hate on you. And I'll just sit back and laugh because you're a fucking idiot. You can't say that, oh, everyone's opinion is correct, because it's fucking not. Some people have really outrageous opinions, like vaccines cause autism. That's not, they try and say that's fact, but no, one, that's hardly an opinion, that's just ignorance, and they're wrong. Your opinion is wrong, and you're stupid, and you're causing people, not people, innocent kids who don't know any better to get sick because you're an idiot. That's really all I can say about that. So, I really need to get back on the topic of H3H3 here, guys. I'm sorry I keep getting sidetracked, I'm just very adamant about this whole situation. H3H3 in the video did say that he targets people, and, well, while he targets people and says that, like, okay, I'm going to use Joey World's Tour for an example now, he says that Joey World's Tour has an eating disorder. Well, I mean, it's one thing to have an eating disorder, but it's a completely another thing to just not seek help for your eating disorder and then just go on YouTube and post videos of you eating stuff like a barbarian. When I was going through my shit, I wouldn't upload videos of me dropping Xanax every hour and just crying in my bed and just, you know, making completely terrible content that people, for whatever reason, watched. If he really has a disability, then he needs to seek help on his own, not upload videos and expect white knights to come to his aid and protect him through the whole thing and say, no, you don't have a problem, blah, blah, blah. I mean, that's ridiculous. And I think H3H3 is kind of just almost took that opinion to seem like the good guy. You know, if you're going to, if you want to claim that you have a mental disability and that's why people can't make fun of you, well, then get help for it. I mean, the biggest thing that happened in my life was when I went to a fucking therapist. I just talking to someone about your issues, having someone who listens, okay? It later on, that got replaced with a girlfriend who I'm no longer with right now, but just having someone to talk through your issues with is the biggest help you can get. Uploading videos of you just self-indulging yourself and refusing to get help or seek help, that's not a cry for help, that's a cry for attention. And I'm sorry, I don't give attention or credit or anything to attention whores. Just like that Leave Britney Alone guy or girl or what, I don't know if it was a guy or a girl, I'm sorry if that offends anyone, but I genuinely don't know, so fuck you if that's offensive, because if I don't know, I don't, like, what the fuck do you want from me? You want me to take a guess and risk being even more offensive? Eat a dick. I'm sorry, that's one thing that really pisses me off. But that person just uploaded that video for attention. Everyone knows it was for attention. Leave Britney alone! No, if you really were that fucking adamant about getting people to leave Britney alone, well, then maybe you should start realizing that Britney's a shitty example. And for her fan base, who is mostly kids under the age of 18, you shouldn't be setting a shitty example. And just because you don't fall in that 18 or under fan base doesn't mean that everyone else is wrong, okay? There's no one uploaded a video going, leave Justin alone! No, he's a shitty example for his fan base. 13-year-old girls watch him. Okay, if you want to smoke pot, go ahead and smoke pot, but you don't need to be so fucking vocal about it. I mean, I'm vocal about it because I smoke pot, but that's because my demographic is 18 to 34, and people understand that smoking pot is not bad for you at this age. But if a 13-year-old sees that the guy that they're in love with and want to marry is smoking pot, they might think, oh, if I smoke pot, I'll be more like Bieber. And I will not sit here and tell you pot hurts you. I will tell you, however, taking any drug before your brain is fully developed is a terrible idea. And I don't think putting your kids on antidepressants, Adderall, ADHD meds, etc. is good for you. I feel like I fried my brain as a kid because I got prescribed Xanax, which led to an addiction to Xanax, which I'm not going to go into it too much, but the doctor that prescribes 15-year-old Xanax, he should absolutely lose his medical license. There's no circumstance that a 15-year-old should have Xanax. I'm sorry, and I went into his office, and I just called him out. Like, I didn't do it in front of the, like, lobby or anything to completely make a scene, but I was like, I need to talk to you, and I told him, like, you are the reason I had depression, and I hope you fucking just pain over that, because you fucking ruined my life for 3 years by giving me fucking pills for a problem that could have been solved by talking to a therapist. But guess what? Doctors don't want to recommend therapists because big pharma companies will give them payouts and things like that. And if you don't believe me that doctors receive money from big pharma, look into it. I'm not making this shit up. They get money based on how many prescriptions they hand out, and the fact that we live in a world where doctors can profit more by handing out prescriptions leads me to believe that our country isn't going forward in any, no matter who gets elected, especially because no candidate is running on we need to tear down Big Pharma, because Big Pharma is the fastest and biggest growing economic solution in the country, and holy shit, I got completely off topic. So, back to attention whores. Anyway, just making a video claiming that people are targeting you or that people are being targeted isn't going to solve this problem. If Joey Salads really has an eating disorder, he should go see someone about it, not upload videos about it. That's a terrible, terrible idea. That's like telling an alcoholic that rather than going to Alcoholics Anonymous, you should just start uploading videos of you getting drunk because you're a funny drunk. That is the worst advice you could ever give another human being, and the same logic applies to a person who is creating videos of them eating food. And I don't believe Joey Salads claims to have an eating disorder. I think he's just a food lover who eats a lot of food, makes funny videos about it. That's the end of it. But I think H3H3 blew it out of proportion by saying he has an eating disorder. I would like to know where he got this information. I would admit if I'm wrong that he hasn't, or if he admits that he has an eating disorder, I would publicly admit that I'm wrong, but I really don't think he has an eating disorder. Being fat doesn't always assume having an eating disorder. I was fat. I was 221 pounds, 5'8" in sixth grade, okay? That is fat. I had no eating disorder. I just really liked eating, you know? And you could say that's an eating disorder, but no, it wasn't. Because I got to a certain point where I found out that exercising is actually a lot of fun. I still eat the same amount of food I did back then. I get McDonald's 3 times a week. I usually get a Big Mac, a Bacon McDouble, 10-piece chicken nugget, large fry, and a large sweet tea at one sitting of a fucking McDonald's. I eat so much fucking food, but I jog 3 miles a day and work out every day to counteract that, as well as I try and cut back on sugar. I don't eat things like ice cream and whatnot. I still have sweet tea because, oh, it's so good. So, you know, being fat and having an eating disorder are two different things. And I would also like to point out that as much as H3H3 wants to seem like the white knight in the situation, he's a commentator too. He watches another person's video, commentates over it, and criticizes it. And I said in the beginning of this video, I hate the word commentator. He's a YouTube critic as well. Sure, he only targets big YouTubers, but does that mean a big YouTuber can't possibly have autism? Is that what the point you're trying to get across, that Chris from Prank Invasion can't possibly have Asperger's or anything like that? Some people are really high-functioning autistic people, but yet you can make fun of them. I'm not saying Chris is autistic or anything like that, but we both know he makes cringeworthy videos, and there's something wrong upstairs. Like, no one just goes around hiring actors to make out with him to get famous. Like, okay, I think he needs a therapist more than I do at this point. Like, at least I accept that I've only had one girlfriend, and that I've really only ever even kissed one girl, so screw it. I mean, I accept that, and, you know, at least I've had one. That's where I leave that. I don't go around hiring fucking prostitutes to have sex with me and make out with me. So, all in all, I think H3H3 kind of, he did the right thing, but he focused on the wrong problem, and that's why I made this video. And I know this went on for a long time, but I really hope that you guys will start understanding that these big YouTubers, any of them, H3H3, Leafy, PewDiePie, name any YouTuber, even small guys like me, you can't blame them for what their fans do after watching their content. Now, if you watch, I believe it's the fucking, I can't remember his name. The vegan guy that Grade A always makes fun of, the super vegan, I don't know, that idiot, where he makes death threats on stream and tells people to go, like, criticize and make fun of other people. Okay, if you are taking shit that far and telling your fans to go hate, then you deserve to be hated on. But that guy received pretty much no hate other than from Grade A. Which, thank you, Grade A. You're another one of the reasons I started making YouTube videos. And you're kind of what inspired me to make commentaries. Although, I'm so shitty at art, I can't even do stick figures. But thank you, regardless. Even though there's no way you're watching this, this will probably get 20 views. So, I just want to get the point across that do not hate YouTubers for what their fans do. Okay, I'm sure that Leafy feels terrible about what happened. I'm sure H3H3 feels bad that he had to make fun of Leafy. And honestly, I bet even Tommy feels kind of bad that this whole situation, like, just brought so much shit into both of their lives. And I'm talking about him and Leafy. Like, it was just a simple criticism video. I bet Tommy would not have given a shit if no one started threatening to kill him, okay? It wouldn't have been an issue. And most people that Leafy makes videos about don't have an issue because his fans don't threaten to kill them. But for whatever reason, they blew this video way out of proportion. So that's just my two cents on it. I hope you guys agree with me, because really, this is just... it's getting to the point that the YouTube community is becoming pure cancer. Even the main content creators are being cancer now, because not even the content they're creating is cancer, but because the people they watch it is cancer. And I really hope that we can get to a point where you can criticize someone on YouTube and make a video of that criticism and then not threaten to kill them and their fucking family. My God, guys. I don't know, like, where these people were raised, what kind of fucked up childhood they have, or, you know, who's, like, what uncle touched them while they were a little kid. But if the only way you could make yourself feel better about being a human being is by making fun of other people for their, like, autism and just hating on them, telling them to kill themselves, you seriously are at the point where you need to get mental help. That's not normal. That is not how people function, and you're the issue, not the person you're making fun of. So if you've ever left a comment telling someone to go kill themselves or whatever, I mean, I just go fucking get help, dude. Like, if you want to tell me to go kill myself for saying that, do it. I don't care. All right. I've dealt with so much adversity in my life. I feel like a lot of the shit that I've gone through has made me so strong that if even 100,000 people start watching this and just start saying, go kill yourself, I can't believe you would hate on Leafy and h3h3, well, I feel like I'll be fine with it. I can accept that I'll never have a YouTube career, even though, like, ever since I was 12, like, my biggest dream was just to be a YouTuber, and only recently have I ever just fucking started to do it, and I've been doing pretty well. But if you guys really hate me for making this video, I'll be able to rest peacefully knowing that, all right, well, at least I got my opinion out into the world, and hopefully a few people listen to it, and just like Tommy wants to, just make the world a better place, one good deed at a time, all right? So that's all. That's what I'm going to leave this video at. I love you guys so much. Thank you so much for the support I've been getting recently. I've been getting 500 views a day. I love you all, and I hope you enjoyed this really long video. Peace out. Don't hate.